Buongiorno e benvenuti alla celebrazione del matrimonio del nostro caro amico Stember e Antonio.
Good day and welcome to the wedding celebration of our dear friends Stember and Tony. Friends, family, and honored guests, we are gathered here today in this beautiful garden on this glorious afternoon to witness and support this couple as they continue their life journey together as husband and wife. We are blessed to have with us today their immediate families, as well as their numerous friends. It is testimony to the love they share with each other and with all of us. Though our gathering marks a formal initiation of their union, we recognize that the bond between Stember and Tony has existed for some time. Like a pair of explorers who today embark on an expedition that is sure to be filled with excitement and adventure, both unexpected and even challenging at times, this couple has undertaken serious preparations for their journey. Gifted with the love and guidance of their family and all of you whom they recognize as their extended family, they have arrived at this moment ready to engage in a lifelong commitment to one another. They have asked me to thank you all for joining this celebration today and appreciate your friendship and love. I would ask at this time that we take a moment to remember all those loved ones who are no longer with us or are not able to be with us today, but who have graced the lives of Stember and Tony. Tony would like to make special mention of his dad, Charles, who was a great source of inspiration. Tony misses him daily, but knows he is here in spirit. Let us remember them with love and gratitude and know they are looking down upon us today, verse 1. Thank you. Their story began when Tony's longtime friend Ken invited him to attend a party at his girlfriend, News Dress Shop on Chestnut. It was there he spotted Stember and struck up a conversation. Being the jokester that he is, if they were at a bar, Tony would have offered to buy her a drink. But since they were in a dress shop, Tony instead says, "I'll buy you any dress in the shop." Trying very hard to be funny. Needless to say, Stember thought this was a bit weird and presumptuous. Really? What a pickup line. He was definitely a on shaky ground, just like that dog walking across the room. They all went out for sushi afterwards. Tony positions himself next to her, and he successfully started digging himself out of the very deep hole he had dug. At the end of the night, Tony got her phone number, but he was one digit off. Wrong number. Not to be disturbed, our hero asked Stember's best friend, Sora, who then helped him get connected. Thank you, Sora. Their first date in San Francisco was at a French restaurant, followed by a walk into Union Square. Wanting to capture the moment, Tony takes out his cell phone and snaps a picture of Stember next to the heart. The very first picture of Stember on their very first date. After many more dates, the connection between them was effortless and easy. They wanted to spend more time with each other. It's been almost 3.5 years now. Our hero decides to propose to her at that very spot, in front of the heart in Union Square. So he bought the ring, told her that their friend Cameron wanted to try out this new happy hour place. She said. However, she noticed that Tony was acting a bit weird. Why was he dressed so nicely for a casual happy hour? And why was he insisting that she wear something nice too? It was strange enough for Stember to remark, "Are you going to do something?" Oh no, does she know? Stember brushes it off. Tony gets nervous as they near Union Square. They stop at the heart. "Sweetie, sit down here," Tony says, as he is pointing to the exact location where that first picture was taken. "Why are we stopping here? Aren't we supposed to meet Cameron at this happy hour place?" she exclaimed. Wow, he's really acting bizarre, she thought. Tony pulls out his phone and frantically tries to find the picture of their first date. He had practiced exactly what he was going to say, but things were just not going as planned. Aw, he finally finds the picture. Meanwhile, Stember is sitting at the heart and not sure what to make of this awkward behavior. She's never seen Mr. Confident get so nervous. And all she can make out is, "Remember this picture?" Mumble, mumble. "We've been together for a very long time," more mumbling. "And it was really nice knowing you." Needless to say, Stember was horrified. "Is he breaking up with me here?" I've been waiting a month to tell this story.
Wow.
It was then he dropped to one knee and popped the question. When he finally looked up, Stember had a huge smile on her face and said, "Now, as funny as this is, and believe me, I've been laughing over this story for months now, all you have to do is spend some time with them to see their love in action. It is comfortable, honoring, respectful, and equal, but most of all, loving. Very, very loving." Before exchanging their gifts, Stember and Tony would like to recognize their happiness and strength, not only as a couple, but also as two independent individuals. And as part of their commitment to one another, they seek an equally deep commitment to their own personal growth and to preserving the integrity of their individuality. Here I invoke the words of Barbara Cage. Life is a partnership of two unique people who bring out the very best in each other and who know that even though they are wonderful as individuals, they are even better together. The mothers of the bride and groom will now come forward as we honor them as the matriarchs of their respective families and to help us for the next part of the ceremony. Please.
It's okay, Anne.
Oh, that's good.
These mothers were the first to kiss their children and bring them into this world. And today, a mother's love, together with their blessings, will be the first to send them on their way to their new life together as husband and wife. Mothers, will you please give your child a kiss? Now please change places so that you may welcome the other child into your respective families and end with a kiss for them too. Now with a good wine, please embrace each other. And you may return to where you are standing. Kindly listen to the gifts written by these two as an offering to each other on this, their very special day. Neither of them has seen or heard this part of the celebration before. It is as much a surprise to them as it is to you. Please hold hands. Someone once said, marriage is not about finding the best partner. It's about being the best partner. So with that said, I shall ask, Tony, do you have a gift you would like to bestow upon your beloved before all gathered here today?
I do. My dearest Stember, I am one lucky guy. I found you, my best friend, and the love of my life. And now we're getting married. I cannot be happier to take this next step together as your husband. You always make me feel great, Stember. You're always so cheerful and full of energy. Those goofy smiles with your mouth open really are long off in the morning when you put your head on my shoulder. Sheer heaven. Even when you drag me out of bed at 6 a.m. in the morning to take a 10-mile run and I don't want to go, you always seem to know what's good for me and you always point me in the right direction. I love our adventures together too. My best friend and I together, just the two of us, exploring something new, something challenging, but mostly just being together with you. As we take this next step together, I offer this gift to you, Stember. I promise to keep your life exciting and full of exploration and adventure. I promise to plan for our future and to try to achieve our common goals together. I promise to support you with what goals that are important to you. I promise to try to make you laugh and to try to make you happy every day of our life. I promise to be there for you when you need me. Lastly, I promise not to try to change you. I love you just the way you are. Stember, I love you more today than yesterday, and I'll love you more tomorrow than today.
And Stember, do you have a gift you would like to bestow upon your beloved before all gathered here today?
I do. Hey, Burrito. Can you believe the day has finally arrived? And I'm standing here in front of you, minutes away from being in front of you. Time has gone by so fast, close to 4 years since we met. In those 4 years, we shared lost battles. I've learned so much about you. For example, you'd make a hideous cross-dresser. I saw you Halloween, and that beard does not go with that Princess Leia. All jokes aside, I've always been happy in my life. Pushing random buttons on video poker instantly becoming $5,000 richer. My biggest jackpot is you. Riches to last a lifetime on so many levels. You are the pal in the pal, the O in spaghetti. On this day, I'm marrying my best friend, the one I laugh with, live for, and dream of. Tony, I love you with all my heart and soul.
If you'd like to clap, it's okay.
Yay! Yeah.
So today we celebrate their union, and as they commit themselves to a future together, they do so with the support, love, and encouragement from all of us. They extend their blanket of love to include us as well. And now, as is the tradition in our society, they will state their intention to be united as husband and wife. Dave, Tony's brother, Dan, please have the rings.
Good job, Dave.
Hey, Dave.
If you only knew how much he had to practice. These rings are a symbol of your union. Your lives will now be joined in one unbroken circle. Wherever you go, may you always return to one another in togetherness. Wherever you go, may you find in each other the love for which you both yearn. Wherever you go, may you grow in understanding and compassion for each other. May the home you establish together be a place of sanctuary, within which many will find there a friend. And lastly, may these rings symbolize the touch of the spirit of peace and love in your hearts. Tony, please take Stember's left hand and place this ring on her ring finger and repeat after me. I, Tony.
I, Tony.
Take Stember into my heart as my wife.
Oh, jeez.
Promising to talk less about golf.
Promising to talk less about golf.
Pick out more colorful clothes besides brown and gray.
Blue. Besides brown and gray.
They have overdone it.
Love it.
Honor and cherish her.
Honor and cherish her.
In times of giants wins and losses.
In times of giants wins and losses.
Through
all the days before me.
Stember, please take Tony's left hand and place this ring on his ring finger and repeat after me. Here. I, Stember.
I, Stember.
Take Tony.
Take Tony.
Into my heart as my husband.
Into my heart as my husband.
Promising to put my dirty dishes in the dishwasher. Expand your cooking skills beyond microwaving. Honor and cherish him.
Honor and cherish him.
In times of PGA tours and golf games.
In times of PGA tours and golf games.
Through all the days before me.
Through all the days
And to all of you who have nurtured Stember and Tony, aided them along the path to this great love, now bestow your blessing on their marriage and their family.
We do.
We do.
All right.
Stember and Tony, may the warmth of your love melt away barriers as the sun melts snow. May you rise to the challenge of the adventures that life brings you. Together, recognized from this day forward by your parents, families, and friends as one family. On a personal note, allow me to bestow upon the newlyweds the following blessing of my own, entitled, May You Always. Stember, may you always hold hands and sneak kisses and hugs for no reason. May you always laugh together, cry together, and be there for each other. May you always be silly. May you never stop talking or sharing or understanding each other. May you keep wishing on stars, whispering secrets, and dreaming up wild adventures. And may you always love each other the way you so evidently do today. And now the moment you've all been waiting for.
Oh, yeah.
Inasmuch as Stember and Tony have consented to marry before this esteemed company, have pledged their faith and declared their unity by each giving and receiving a ring, and are now joined by mutual esteem, love, and devotion. Then by the power vested in me, by this great state of California, on this day, Friday, the 20th of September, in the year 2013, I do hereby pronounce you, wait for it, husband and wife, or in your case, chimichanga and burrito. Shortly to mingle with everyone. Please too, don't forget to sign their guest tree. Ladies and gentlemen, family, friends, honored guests, it gives me immense pleasure and joy to present to you today, walking for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Tony Tang. I got it. Mr. and Mrs. Lambo.
I got a couple.
You're qualified drivers.